So Pete, you posted on WeChat that many people lined up in many cities, nine cities around the world, to just to look at your phone, touch your phone for 2 or 3 minutes. Why people would do that? They flew all over to just to touch the phone for 2 or 3 minutes.
刘总，你在这个微信上呢发布了信息，然后在全球的9个城市呢有这么多人去排长队、排长龙，只是去体验你的手机产品，只是去触摸他们。你到底是怎样做到这个效果呢？的确，我们昨天在全球9个城市发起的这个体验活动，基本上都是人满为患，也是出乎我的意料吧。 但是呢，我觉得根本的原因还是因为我们这1年多的时间，做了一个 OnePlus One 这个好的产品，然后跟我们的用户很平等的去互动，所以呢，全球有这么多的喜欢 OnePlus 的人。那我们第二款产品在28号发布，所以真的我们当时看的也是全球的这个媒体都在关注我们，包括我们的用户。昨天我们也是，的确所有人都想去看一看一加2这个产品。 并且我们看到所有的媒体和用户的评价都非常的高，最终还是产品，我觉得。So
it's a very competitive.
Yes, sorry. Yesterday when we had a launch event in the 9 cities, which is a customer experience event, and actually the reactions of the customers are way out of our expectations. I believe that our success was achieved because we made a good product. And during the past year, the OnePlus One has received very high remarks from our customers all over the world. So the, now it's a create a ripple effect for our next product, which is going to be launched on the 28th.
So there are many offerings in the smartphone market. You know, we've got Apple, of course, and then Samsung, Xiaomi, and many new players. And what is the competitive edge of OnePlus?
在移动电话呢的有这么多的这个品牌对吗？譬如是苹果、三星，还有小米，在这么竞争的市场上，这个 OnePlus 的优势是什么呢？这是我经常被媒体问的一个问题，但是我往往会反问媒体一个问题，我说如果你今天要自己买一部手机。 你有什么选择？但得到的答案往往都是说苹果，然后第二个就会很犹豫，不知道是选什么。所以从这个你就可以看出这是一个巨大的机会。为什么大家只会有苹果一个选择？但是手机是个很差异化的一个产品。Actually, I've been asked this question quite a lot, almost by all the media. And very often, I will ask them back this. I ask them, if you would buy the next mobile phone, which brand will you choose? So very often, their answer will start with Apple, and then they will hesitate or they will pause to think. So to me, this signifies a great opportunities in the market, and that's why we are confident for our product development.
You sold 1.5 million OnePlus One, and 60% of them were sold in overseas markets. And the Chinese market is becoming super, super competitive. You add Lei Jun, the founder of Xiaomi, at Weibo, complaining about, you know, attacks from his staff. Can you tell us a little bit, are you going to, you know, expand your market shares in market in China? How are you going to achieve that?
那个，但是一加一呢，在全球售卖了150万。 这么多的数字，然后呢，60%都是海外的市场，对吗？然后呢，在这个这个社交媒体上呢，这个 at 雷军就是小米的创办人，他接到了他的员工一个投诉，对吗？你对于这个事你有什么回应？
那是因为我们在 OnePlus 2 刚发布时，就看到有这个。 对方的员工有在攻击我们，因为我们从来是不去攻击其他的竞争对手，我们都说自己做好自己，就是安心做好产品。 所以呢，我是希望那天我为什么艾特给雷军，就希望大家能够，都是做好自己，不要去互相攻击，然后让整个行业是一个比较良性的竞争，因为最终消费者最终选的是产品，不是说谁会骂人，这个是我的观念。Yes,
when we were about to launch a OnePlus 2, there in the social media there has been some attack from a staff of the Xiaomi. So the reason I responded on the social media is because I want to clarify to an address to Lei Jun that the market should be a peaceful and a constructive environment for all to coexist. So I want to address this and to create not a hostile environment for the mobile phone market.
You really like somebody's comments that OnePlus is like a quietly handsome man, and you said you identify with that comment. And why can you tell why is that? It's you have to, everybody is so excited, everybody is so competitive, and why do you think that it's important to be quiet, to be focused?
因为呢，有很多人呢，就是形容 OnePlus 是一个安静的美男子，对吗？那在这个竞争这么强烈的这个市场环境下，你为什么可以保持这个安静的状态，这个平和的心境呢？你觉得这个是重要吗？因为在我们的价值观里面和理念里面，就是一切是以产品说话，就是产品是我们的核心竞争力。所以我们都说我们自己把产品和服务做好。 这个企业不成功的难，并且我们这么多年的经验也告诉我们，因为今天也是个创业者的大会，我一直跟很多创业者讲，不要看太多表面的东西，而要看本质的东西，本质就是产品。Because
our core value is in the quality of our product, so I believe that if we focus on improving or develop the good quality of our product, it is the ultimate importance.
So therefore, I think today we are at a startup event, and I have been working with many startups over the years, and I always advise them to not look at the frivolous things, but focus on their core value, which is their product and the services they are offering.
So OnePlus is a rare example that it's a bigger brand in overseas markets than in China. Can you share a little bit what is the biggest challenge as a Chinese brand to expand in the to establish your brand in the overseas markets?
一家呢是一个很特别的例子啊，就是说，你们的这个市场呢，在海外的市场的占有率比在中国的市场还要大。那作为一个就是打出海外的全球的一个品牌，你觉得你们的
这个怎么样可以造成了这么好的这个现象？最大的挑战是什么？作为一个中国的产品，最大的挑战是什么？作为一个中国的产品，你们最大的挑战是什么？我是这么看，就中国现在做产品，我觉得已经是有很多很优秀的公司，就在产品上是有很多很优秀的公司，但是呢，怎么样能够真的进到欧美的市场？ 一个很大的这个，我觉得还是一个文化的认同。就我们说，我们要做一个从一开始要做一个国际化的品牌，那这个时候我们更多的去包容这个全球的不同用户的他的一些习惯，包括我们的员工也是来自十九个国家。那怎么样成为国际化的品牌？就是我们要有很强的包容性、开放的心态，而不是说我们招一堆的员工进来之后，然后让他按照我们中国的形式方式去做。
So as you know, in China, the mobile phone market is already, you know, very competitive. So when we started our company, we already positioned the OnePlus as an international brand, and we have staff of from over 19 countries. We want to keep an open mind to absorb and learn all the elements the customers all over the world they want. So we cannot just hire a group of international staff and then ask them to do the traditional Chinese way. So this is our positioning to position as a global brand.
Another question is, there are so many smartphones, and they all kind of look quite similar and function in very similar ways. And how do you innovate? What do you do? Like, do you do a lot of things yourself, or you use outside help?
有这么多智能电智能手机呢，就是说，其实看起来大家的产品都差不多，功能也差不多，对吗？你们是有什么计划，怎样可以脱颖而出呢？因为我本身是做产品做了十多年，我是从来不会认为说现在的产品就一定是完美的。我针对任何一个东西，我会问为什么。比如说我们在一加二上做的一些创新。 那个我们做了一个勿扰的开关，可能在07年 iPhone 发布的时候，它做了一个静音的开关。那个时候我非常震惊，为什么会有这么一个开关，非常好用。
Mute.
但是到了今天8年以后，整个使用场景已发生了巨大的变化。我们要问为什么还是这么一个开关，而不是再加入个勿扰的开关。因为以前我们是怕打扰别人，现在是我们更多是被骚扰，所以我是希望更安静，所以我们加入了一个。 这个勿扰的开关。
Because the many phones seem to have the similar function, and then I sometimes question when the iPhone first launched, they have a mute on button, right? And I found it astonishing. But now, after so many years, I question that. From my experience over 10 years in the product development, how come this has not been improved? And personally, I don't like to disturb other people. So now that we developed the non-disrupt on switch, that because I also don't want other people to disturb us now that we're in the mobile age.
So how do you position OnePlus? In such a competitive market. We talk about it backstage, you use the analogy of the car market. Can you talk a little bit about that?
那你在 OnePlus 怎样是继续的创新去更加的就是增强竞争力? 刚才呢我们在后台呢有谈论过就是你用车这个车的行业做了一个举例，你可不可以让我们分享?
主要是定位，因为手机这个市场大家可以看到，好像是有很多的巨头，可能会形成垄断。但是在我的观念里面，手机是一个非常差异化的市场，就很难形成这个说一家或两家独大。就像我经常举的例子，就是汽车，汽车发展这么多年几十年，但是呢，你会发现这么多的品牌，因为它是很差异化的一个市场，每个需求是不一样的。 所以你必须要找准自己的定位，然后你去一直扎根下去做，你就能够形成你自己的这个一个细分的市场。但是这个市场这么大，比如我们一年几十亿的市场规模，你只要做一个很小的细分市场，你可能一年几千万台是，其实是很容易的。
Yes, in the mobile phone industry, actually it's a very diversified industry. Just like in comparison to the car industry, over so many years of development, we see there's all these brands coexist, all different styles. So I believe that in the mobile phone, that it is also a huge market. I believe the market is over billions of quantity each year. And if we can just have a small portion, a small market share, even talking about the tens of millions, already I see a very big market.
There are a lot of talks about building ecosystems, and Xiaomi, for one, has invested in over a dozen companies. Is there any plan for you? Is there anything the startups here can join you? And if you were going to establish some kind of partnership, what is it going to be like?
就是说，因为呢，我们一直现在提到这个生态系统。 对吗？那那个 OnePlus 呢？我知道你们也投资了几
小米，
哦，小米对，不好意思， 小米呢，它也投资了几十家的公司。那对，现在今天我们有这么多的 startups， OnePlus 有没有兴趣找一些合作伙伴，或者是怎样可以增强你们的公司的定位呢？
生态系统我是这么看，我觉得我们更多是要做好自己的平台，就像我们现在有很多的 app， 移动的 app， 那我们怎么样把这个手机的这个平台做好，能够接入更多的服务，而不是什么东西都自己做。就我的观点就是我们把平台打好，这手机是一个智能终端，很好的平台接入，这个只要是用户觉得最好的这个服务，这个是我们未来的一个方向，怎么打造这个平台。
So our future direction is actually to concentrate to build a very good platform for all the collaborators. I believe that we need to focus on our core value, which is the core product quality, and then to support the ecosystem.
所以我们是愿意，我们一直说要做一个开放的平台，愿意跟所有人合作，只要有好的，我们都愿意合作。
And the most importantly, we value the customer experience. So we are willing to make an open platform so that to absorb and attract the other collaborators to build the best platform for customers all over the world.
You told me you like Ben Horowitz, the hard thing about hard thing much better than Peter Thiel's From Zero to One.Why is that?
你提到呢，就说就是比起这个 Peter Thiel 他的这本书《从零到一》，你说过你更喜欢、更推荐呢另外一本书，就是这个 Ben Horowitz 的《创业维艰》，是为什么呢？
这是我是认为，就我个人是很反感一些。很虚的概念，比如说什么风口啊、抓机会，因为这种机会的东西是，很难去求，这个可能是要运气的。但是我们更多的事情，怎么样把自己最基础、你该做的事情做得扎实，不要每天想着去找机会。所以我一直给我们所有的创业者的一个建议就是，不要看那些虚的东西，踏踏实实做好你自己本分的事情，一步一步来。因为创业是一个很艰苦的过程。不要老是想抓机会。
I believe that to start a company as entrepreneurs, the path is a hard one, right? Therefore, I advise all the startup and entrepreneurs not just to look at the frivolous things, but focus on really their core value, not just to be opportunist, and not just focus on the gimmicky.Aspect of business, so therefore I recommend this book.
因为抓机会这个可能是你一时的成功，但是你怎么样保证你做一个我们想做一个几十年的甚至百年的企业，这个一定不是你每天想着抓机会能取得成功的。
Yes, because capturing opportunities might get some short-term successes, but to build a long-term established business and brand.I believe that we need to focus on the stability and the core quality.
Okay, thanks, Pete.
Thank you.
Okay, 谢谢
Thank you, everyone.